Hello and the warmest of welcomes to this new episode of Rambling Reviews right here on Mason's Music Library. I'm your humble host, Carl Mason, and in this week's episode, we're discussing the truly remarkable album, Currents, by the one and only Tame Impala. Now, this is a project rich in sonic texture and psychedelic ambience, and it's an album I've been really excited to talk about ever since I started this channel. So without further ado, let's get straight into the review. Currents is a third studio effort by the tremendous Tame Impala, an Australian act formed by the now legendary Kevin Parker, the man behind the music who not only wrote and performed the vast majority of this album, but also produced and mixed it. Now, this is made all the more impressive by just how ambitious this project is, featuring some of the best production, dare I say it, from its genre in some time. Now, Currents was a follow-up to the group's other highly successful albums, 2010's Interspeaker, as well as 2012's Lonerism. That was one of the albums that really turned a lot of people onto their music, with its psychedelically throwback style that drew sonically from the sounds of the 1960s and 1970s psychedelic rock scene, like Revolver-era Beatles and Supertramp, for example. Now, these two Tame Impala albums had, for so many, represented a return to that musical expression that had not been explored by a new band in some time. The expression of the psychedelic experience. Now, this album Currents sought to, it seems, to move away from that more traditional approach and towards their own artistic direction, drawing influences from dance music, synth pop, and even disco, all whilst maintaining a firm grasp on the signature elements of the band's music, allowing Parker the opportunity to express his own completely unique sound that I simply adore. This album Currents was recorded between 2012 and 2015, primarily within Parker's own home recording studio, and you really feel in this album the closeness it had to him, as his project is saturated in detail and the attention to it. I feel this project could only have been made a result of the personal submergence into both the music as well as his self, as Currents explores the process of inner transformation that occurs after a big change in our lives. Now, there's no way of knowing exactly what transformation Kevin was talking about on this album, but it appears from the outside to be a result of a fallen relationship and how sudden shifts in our life force us to reevaluate our lives and will help us to either evolve or regress. Now, this album appears to explore the latter of the two, because much of the subject matter on this project appears to be about accepting change and allowing it to change yourself instead of allowing it to pull the self apart. Take, for example, the incredibly sweet song, Yes, I'm Changing, a serene little number that explores change and moving on and how in turn this leads to personal growth. Just give it a listen. Yes, I'm changing. Yes, I'm gone. Yes, I'm older. Yes, I'm moving on. Now, I must say, I really do adore this song and its powerful message. It is honestly unique in its exploration, but not unique within the own human experience. We all change. Change is all we can ever really do, as the passage of time only represents the passage of change. So just remember, my friends, the choice is yours on how you change. Now, I wanted to touch on the musical direction of this project because I do find it to be a very interesting one, shifting significantly from the sound the band had set up with their previous projects, with their very pre-established indie psych rock aesthetic, something triumphed by their fans for its contribution to the revival of one of myself and many others' favourite genres. Now, Currents evidently was inspired to take that psychedelic, transient effect and carry it over into different genres of music, such as disco and dance, for example, forming a real fusion of styles to, in my opinion, excellent effect. And it's that psychedelic feeling that is a cornerstone of their musical expression. Take, for example, the fantastic song The Moment, that features such an incredible blend of musical directions from bubblegum pop to prog rock, but it's all bound together thanks to that signature psychedelic essence that is honestly very hard to classify. Now, the final section of this song actually for me is very reminiscent of another one of their more iconic tracks, Elephants from 2012's Lonerism. I think those marching synthesized sections just draw you in the most magnificent way, and the music is just so hypnotic, and it's this kind of effect that I'm struggling to define with words here, so I think I should just let the music speak for itself. Just take a listen to this end section of the song, The Moment, and I think you'll know exactly what I mean. Okay, so now I just want to take the opportunity to talk about what this album means to me, as it really is an album to me that is special, as I was first introduced to it by a good friend at a time of real evolution for myself. I felt the tides of change are coming, and this album had a hand in helping me to embrace that change. Now, this album has since subsequently returned to me at times of real transformation. Take, for example, deciding to talk about it for this review. I mean, for some reason, this album just called to me this week, and I'm so grateful for that. This project is such a gentle album, and it's one rich with intimate insight, reminding you that you're not alone in your experience of change. It's almost as if this album acts as a bit of a lighthouse to me, whilst caught in the tempest of transformation. Alright then, ladies and gentlemen, that's almost it for this week's episode of Random Reviews, but before I wrap it up, I want to briefly share my three personal highlights from this superb album, starting out with 'Cause I'm a Man, an enchanting little ballad that explores the distance between men and women, and how that separation often in a relationship leads to failed communication and foolish action. Now, this song has a captivating tone that comes from the firm bassline that guides the song, allowing it a foundation for other little effects and accents. Now, this is a more sonically sparse song, but one that has such a fantastic composition to it. Next up is another song that features a remarkable composition, and that's the lead single, Eventually. A superb synth rock anthem that is just so incredibly unique and has such incredible impact, with its dynamic direction that shows the maturity of Kevin's songwriting style, all whilst having a heart-tugging message about our connection to an imagined future, where all is well, and how we cling to this idea that is ultimately distracts us from being happy in the here and now, which is the only time we truly can be happy. So now for my final personal highlight from Currents, and I'm sure if you're familiar with this album, you'll be able to guess which song I'm referring to here. It's the illustrious album opening track, Let It Happen. Now this is just the most incredible song that has everything I love about the band and much more. Featuring the most diverse musical composition in the band's discography, as well as easily for me the best songwriting, as it takes the listener on a legitimate transient journey. And every time I hear this, I'm just blown away, because it perfectly illustrates the importance of letting go and letting what will happen come to pass. We all try to fight against the tides of change in vain, but the only way to overcome it is by letting it happen. As the Beatles said, turn off your mind, relax, and float downstream. So why not let us just listen to it and simply let it happen? Okay, so on that note, I'm going to have to call it a day for this week's episode of Random Reviews. It was honestly my pleasure today to discuss this fantastic album. Tame Impala are a truly superb outfit, and Kevin truly brought something special to the table with this project. But I would love to hear what you have to say about this album, so why not let me know in the comments what you think. I want this channel to be about conversation, so feel free to join in at any time. And if you enjoyed this week's episode of Random Reviews, I sure would appreciate it if you subscribed to the channel. It would truly mean the world to me. But before you head out, I have this week's recommended listening list for you. Just a few songs that nicely accompany this album. Starting off with Agoraphobia by Deer Hunter, Inner Space by Vanel Williams, it's a cool song, and Life by No Means Least, Keep On Lying by the one and only Tame Impala. So thank you once again for joining me, Carl Mason, for another episode of Random Reviews. It was my utmost pleasure, as always, and I'll see you in the next episode. Take it easy.